All right, today, friends, we're going to be talking about IP, or your intellectual property, and what in the world is Toys R Us doing? You might have missed the news, but yesterday, the entity in charge of the bankruptcy of Toys R Us decided that that was a really, really bad idea, and they were going to pull the brake and jump out of bankruptcy because there's $11 billion at stake in the toy market heading into Q4, which is like tomorrow. So if we go back to July of this year to the MLive Media Group YouTube page that you can see here, I talk about Amazon jumping into that $11 billion hole and what I would do if I was in charge. And the thing I talked about is taking the IP, the intellectual property, and assigning it to another retailer. So call it the Meijer Toys R Us toy line. Because here's the problem with coming out of bankruptcy and everyone being excited about Toys R Us being back. Remember, friends, they closed 735 stores that are all currently Halloween cities. Oh, and they put 33,000 people out of work. It's hard to get all those people back in time for Q4. So instead, the artist formerly known as Toys R Us is gonna do two things. One, they announced on Tuesday they are launching a wholesale business that's called Jeffrey's Toy Box. So the giraffe will now sell toys at wholesale. The other is what myself and a lot of marketers talked about. They're going to rent the IP, rent the name Toys R Us to another retailer, Target, Walmart, etc., that will have their own toy aisle. And then what I've been talking about and I said last night, I think phase two would be reinventing their retail space so to take that IP back and launch another thing. And I realized that last shot was super loud, but if you're reading Hank Green's new novel, you know that if you see a giant 8-foot robot in your city, you stop by and put it on video. And the renting of the IP is interesting given the timing, because one, Q4 is right around the corner, and two, they don't have any inventory to stock their own stores, so they're gonna leverage somebody else's inventory. And this comes on the heel of announcement this morning that Walmart has just become the official home of collectibles. So they've signed with Loot Crate, and they've signed with Funko Pops, and they've signed with McFarlane, some of my favorite current obsessions, and they'll have an entire aisle dedicated to toy collectors. This is much to my wife's chagrin, who had just assumed that Funko Pop would go out of business along with Toys R Us. But I find all this stuff super interesting because the more we talk about radio is dead, TV is dead, retail is dead, everything is dead, somebody comes along and sort of reinvents the space. And so what you'll see time and time again is that the reuse of these spaces, the someone who comes on with a master hand and can do something differently, can reinvigorate these brands. There was no way that Toys R Us was gonna go away forever. I thought it was gonna be a little bit longer than this, but there was no way that the IP was gonna go away forever. And now it comes back as two things: a wholesaler run by a giraffe, and some retailer near you will have a toy aisle that's named Toys R Us. All right, friends, we'll talk tomorrow. If you need anything, it's Eric at MLive.com.